So you see, whereas I was drawing the Kandinskys, and there, at least there was one major or whatever he was, at least he had some idea that when he looks at shapes, he doesn't just, you know what the hell it is. He really, at the moment he saw it, he said, Kandinsky, you know. So that made me feel good. Although I know why I was doing it, because when you're up there 20,000 feet and you look down, believe me, everything is abstraction. But I think also somehow that aspect of viewing something from way above and still become something else, I think that probably propelled me to a degree of looking at it as it is. Okay, this can be art. So to a degree that could, so it's possible that initiated that thing in me to look at that drawings from above become an abstraction. And maybe there's a lot more of that, or maybe it's a lot more of that without me going up there, or all those other problems. So that drawing of abstraction, it came. But it also came because it, to me, a drawing often have a lot of sense of movement without moving. But then again, when that fellow took me to downtown Chicago and I saw abstract, I saw painting. I mean, I saw movement for the first time. I've never seen movement like that, you know. That plus the environment that they were moving about was a painting by itself. And so if I can just take that outside the theater, you know, and I can end up with something very special, but I have not had the opportunity to see that kind of art, you know. I don't know why. I should have gone to downtown Chicago Art Institute, but that was too damn far to go, and I wasn't that high ho at that time on that. But later it happened that I could see there's an art form. And then I started to work like that, and it came naturally. And I remember even Emerson High School, where everybody had to go out to 2 hours drawing the nature, you know? And I told the art teacher, I said, you know, I'm really not interested drawing nature. And she was, I don't understand, I should understand after all these years why she listened to me. She said, no, you just stay in a room and do that. Everybody out, you know. So that was the first time that somebody saw something I did that and said, okay, you do that, you know, and just stay put. So I think she was a very bright teacher to work at that. So everybody was out and I was drawing my abstraction. So that, to a degree, that was the beginning of something. Came from the movement, from the art in the world of ballet, you know. And then when I started to really put things down on paper, they were squares or circles or lines and stuff like that. And for her to say, you stay here and do that, everybody out, you know. And that, so that to a degree was the beginning of something which dealt with the abstract world of painting and drawing. And from that moment on, it was a natural thing for me. So even when I was at Disney, you know, and even like drawing the mushrooms, they are shapes, they are objects, but they move. So again, it works. It's not that far from the ballet Russe de Monte Carlo to a Chinese dance at Disney, you know, because I propelled it into that situation.